hip hop with a purpose. We are the Bombshelter.
I was a mobile DJ since sixth grade, and we used to take the whole house system, like, "Dad, please, please, please." All right. And literally take my dad's stereo to do gigs and then just put it back. And there was no scratching. It wasn't that era at all. You know what I'm saying? Like the 45s, when you go to the record store and there's the top 40 literally in 45s.
Yeah. I lived that life. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, that was where DJing started for me, was like the sixth grader that was, you know, DJing this eighth grader's dance.
I had done a few parties and was feeling myself. And so I went into one of the mobile DJ companies here in town. It was mostly wedding receptions. That is how I met my mentor. His name was Hassan Omari. And when he hired me, he let me know. He's like, "Look, young blood, this ain't what you think it is. This is not. You're not going to be at these weddings cutting it up and doing, you know, fly shit." And I'm like, "Yes, I am." And he was right. But yeah. Hassan put me on, man. He taught me how to get in front of crowds and crowds that don't want to hear me. And you know, and here was the gag I pulled as a wiki DJ doing wedding receptions for, you know, country ass white people. I wasn't really allowed to wiki, but my blend game was insane. I would go from 1999 to Moni to, you know, and I was doing mashups before.
On 45s or 12 inches?
12 inches, 45s, whatever you gave me. Sometimes I would have to play something on a CD and then blend it on off the turntable. Like, we had all of it, you know. Never used a cassette, but we had a cassette player in there because once in a while some woman might come up and go, "Can you play this song? It's really important." And I'm like, "Okay, let me cue it up. I'll play it over here," you know. But the Hokey Pokey on 45 was the real trip, because I would put one copy on each turntable and make it go. You put your right foot in, you put your right foot out, you put your right foot in, and you shake it all about. You do the Hokey Pokey, and then you put your left foot in, you put your right foot out, you put your left foot in. You know, I would freak it to mess people up once they got, you know what I mean? Like once they were in their Hokey Pokey zone, then I would start like messing with them, you know? And I learned that from him. That was a thing he did. And he wasn't even that kind of DJ. He wasn't trying to mix and scratch and shit. He showed me how to flip the Hokey Pokey like that. And that, to me, it spoke to me, because I'm like, "Yo, this is some De La Soul shit that you're doing right now. You don't even know it. You know what I mean? Like, this is some Prince Paul shit you're doing right now, you know?"
You are safe and sound right here with us inside the Bombshelter.